سيئة الحسنة، هو يسيء وأنت تفعل الحسن، هذا هو حسن الخلق. وأسأل الله أن يوفقنا وإياكم وأن يلهمنا تقوى والحسنات وحسن الخلق، ونسأله تبارك وتعالى أن يجزيكم خير الجزاء، وأن يعفو عنكم جميعا وعنا، وأن يغفر لنا ولكم جميعا.
آمين.
وهذا كان دعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: اللهم أني أسألك الهدى والتقى.
آمين.
والعفاف والغنى، أعظم دعاء يا أخوان كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم دائما يكثر منه، لأن التقوى رأس الأمر كما ذكرنا. أسأل الله عز وجل أن يرزقنا وإياكم وأن يوفقنا وإياكم إلى ما فيه التقى والحسنات وحسن الخلق، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.
Sheikh closed out. I'll just mention a hadith that he quoted, and as a statement of the Prophet عليه السلام, which he used to mention a lot. He said, "Oh Allah, I ask you guidance as well as taqwa, as well as chastity, as well as sufficiency."
جزاك الله خيرا يا شيخنا، ونسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعل هذه الكلمة على ميزان حسناتكم يوم تلقاه، إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. الحمد لله يا إخوان. We thank the Sheikh, Sheikh Falah ibn Ismail, حفظه الله تعالى, with that beautiful talk that he just gave. Alhamdulillah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put it.
خلنا ببشرهم ببشارة أخرى.
And Sheikh says, I'm going to give you another good glad tidings.
إحنا العرب عندنا يحبون البشارة كثير جدا.
He says, the Arab, we like to give glad tidings to people all the time.
لذلك اللي يبشر على طول يعطونه شيء يسمونه بشارة، يعني يعطونه جائزة، لا بد من الجائزة.
نعم. So he said the person who gives glad tidings, he said, you know, they give them back some type of prize or something like this.
البشارة النظر في حياة العلماء يا أخوان.
He said this بشارة, this glad tidings is to look in to the lives of the ulama, the people of knowledge.
أولا مالك بن دينار.
He said first Malik bin Dinar.
إمام.
He was an imam.
تابعي جليل.
He was a tabi'i. He was a virtuous tabi'i. The students of the Sahaba.
كان من أبناء الملوك.
He was from the children of some kings at that time, rulers.
في بلاد فارس.
And Fars, which is present-day Iran or that area.
فجاء إلى الإسلام ودخل في الإسلام.
So he accepted Islam.
وكان من أزهد الناس.
And he was from those people who had zuhud, abstinence in the dunya.
فذكروه قالوا حياتك أول.
So they reminded him. They said, "Look at your life before. You had a great life before."
قال والله.
He said, "By Allah."
لا أرى إلا أنني كنت في سجن.
He said, "I don't see except that I was in prison, that I left out of prison."
وكان دائما يقول إنه هذه الدنيا سجن المؤمن.
And he used to always say that this dunya is the prison of the believer.
أبو حنيفة رحمه الله.
أبو حنيفة رحمه الله.
يقول الدنيا سجن المؤمن.
He said the dunya.
وجنة الكافر.
He said the dunya is the prison of the believer and the paradise of the disbeliever.
حياتنا حقيقة الحياة في الآخرة يا إخوان.
He said our real life and our true life is the life of the hereafter.
بشارة أخرى أحمد بن حنبل.
Another بشارة glad tidings. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal.
سجن وعذب كثير.
He was put in prison and he was you know, they punished him and they persecuted him the likes.
قيل له.
It was said to him.
ما تخاف السجن؟
Are you not afraid of prison?
تنازل شوي حتى تخرج.
They said, you know, stop saying what you're saying so that you can leave.
قال السجن دار مثل داري.
He said, "Sijin is a place just like my house."
وفراش مثل فراشي.
He said, "My bed is just like my bed in the house."
بل ربما أفضل.
He said, "Maybe better."
خلاص خلينا في السجن.
He said, "Keep us in prison." And we're going to seek by this being coming closer to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala.
بشارة أخرى.
Another بشارة, glad tidings.
شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله.
شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية, who's known to all of you.
سجن كثير.
He was put in prison many times.
حتى أنه مات في السجن يا أخوان.
Up until the point that he died in prison.
مات في السجن.
He died in prison.
أخرجوه من السجن كفناً.
They took him out of prison on a yeah as his janaza, you know.
قالوا يا شيخ الإسلام خلاص شوية تنازل حتى تخرج.
They told him, Sheikh Islam, stop saying what you're saying so that you can get out of prison.
قال ما يفعل بي أعدائي.
He said, what are my enemies going to do to me?
سجني.
My prison.
خلوة بيني وبين ربي.
In it I have a khalwa, an isolation between me and between my Lord.
طلقت الدنيا وجيت هنا أعيش مع الله سبحانه في الليل وفي النهار.
I left the dunya and I'm here and I'm living with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the day and throughout the night.
قال سجني خلوة وسجني عبادة لله تبارك وتعالى.
He said this cell that I am in, he said is so I can become closer to Allah and worship Allah.
فاصبروا يا إخوان.
So be patient, O brothers.
وصابروا.
And endure patience.
واحتسبوا.
And seek the reward.
وعليكم بالذكر والصلاة والعبادة فإنها أعظم قربة إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
And upon you is to remember Allah and pray and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For verily this is something that's going to make you become closer
الله
to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
كونوا دعاة في السجن. كونوا دعاة.
He said, and be
لغير
callers.
المسلمين.
Be callers to the non-believers while you're in prison. Be callers to the non-believers.
اجتهد أنك تؤثر على غيرك في السجن فيدخل الإسلام. بماذا؟ كيف؟
Work hard so you can call other people to enter Islam. Work hard. Why is this?
حسن الخلق.
How is this? Through good dealings,
والله
good character.
حسن الخلق هو بريدك إلى قلوب الناس يا عبد الله.
He said, حسن الخلق, good character is that which is going to make you reach the hearts of the people.
لذلك الأنبياء كلهم حسن الخلق.
Because of this, all of the prophets, they had حسن الخلق, good character.
وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم.
Allah says about the messenger, indeed you're on a خلق عظيم, from the best and the most best of character.
حسن الخلق, الرحمة, الرفق, اللين, الكلمة الطيبة, الابتسامة, هذه كلها بإذن الله طريقكم إلى هؤلاء السجناء الذين معكم في السجن.
The Sheikh said, being gentle and smiling and having good character and the likes of this, all of this is a way, all of this dealing is a way to reach the people who are the disbelievers.
طيب, يلا تفضل.
نعم. Now, okay. The brothers they wrote these down. نعم. طيب, إخوان. So we're going to ask some questions. Alhamdulillah, there's some very good questions. The first question, it says, يا فضيلة الشيخ, من المعلوم أن العلم هو شرط. I'll read it in English first. It says, it is known that knowledge is a condition for the kalima la ilaha illallah. My question is, what does someone do if when he pronounced the shahadatain and he did not have knowledge of the meaning or he did not fulfill the other conditions? نعم يا شيخ, يقول يا فضيلة الشيخ, من المعلوم أن العلم شرط في كلمة لا إله إلا الله. سؤالي, إذا نطق الإنسان بشهادتين ولم يكن يعرف معناها, يعني فما الحكم؟
يعني هنا في السجن إذا نطق الشهادتين.
You didn't translate it in Arabic?
Yeah, translated in Arabic. No. Was this in prison that he didn't?
In prison.
نعم.
الذنب على وريث الدين.
لا, هذا أو قبل
هي must explain.
قبل مجيء.
لا بد من العلم. العلم شرط. يجب أن يعلم معنى لا إله إلا الله.
He said it's my fault. وريث الدين. He said it's a must that the individual knows.
هذا إن شاء الله طيب. بس حركوه. He wants. يعني مثل السيارة. السيارة تروح تجلس فيها تشتغل. لا, تطلع المفتاح وتحركها تشتغل. وريث الدين حركوه بإذن الله يشرح لكم ويبين لكم.
He said, like a car, you got to turn them on and move them and make them active, and inshallah, I'll do my best to explain it to you. He said, but it is a condition that when you take shahada that you have to have knowledge.
يجب العلم واجب. نعم.
Knowledge is obligatory.
بس يا أخوان جبتوني ما شربتوني ماء. ليش أنتم بخلاء؟
He said he didn't drink no water.
He said,
why? Are you stingy? He didn't get the water.
Because
he didn't like
it
with the ice in it. He just
said, I'm afraid of
the
ice.
You don't like the ice. You got ice in Kuwait, right? I'm sure they got ice over there.
ولا يا شيخ نمشي في الشوارع كله ice, 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 ice. نخاف.
He said he fears too much snow.
نخاف. بعدين تحطون في الماء ثلج هون ما نقدر نشرب.
Well, the Sheikh is from Kuwait. When he seen snow, the Sheikh was, he was amazed at the snow. There's no snow in Kuwait.
تفضل. يعني واحد يسأل إذا كان لديه أخلاق طيبة ولكن مع هذا ليس بمؤمن. يعني إيش يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى عن هذا الرجل؟
أنت اللي معنا الآن.
نعم.
هذا الشخص اللي جاء بهذا السؤال
نعم. عبد الله بن جدعان كان من أحسن الناس أخلاقا في الجاهلية.
He said that an individual by the name of Abdullah, Sahabi.
لا.
Sahabi.
في الجاهلية.
The individual Abdullah ibn Jad'an. He was from the individuals had the greatest of mannerisms in the affair in the time of pre-Islamic period.
أخلاق.
Mannerisms.
بذل، عطاء، كرم، سخاء.
Used to exert himself. Give a lot of good gifts and hospitality and the likes of this.
كان يضرب به المثل في الجاهلية.
Examples used to be put forth for him because of his good mannerisms.
وهو صاحب حلف الفضول الذي دعا إليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما عمره 25 سنة قبل البعثة. حلف الفضول يعني نصرة المظلوم وإعطاء المحروم، يعني عمل مثل حقوق الإنسان. وحضره النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
A charity organization. Yeah. He was in the pre-Islamic period. He used to have sort of like a charity organization.
You know. ينصر المظلوم، يعطي المحروم، المحتاج، المسكين.
The poor and the impoverished, the individuals who needed help, he used to assist them and aid them.
تقول عائشة يا رسول الله.
And Aisha, she said, O Messenger of Allah.
عبد الله بن جدعان.
عبد الله بن جدعان.
هل ينفعه يوم الدين شيء مما فعله في الدنيا؟
She said, "This عبد الله بن جدعان, will it be of any benefit the good that he exerted when he was in the period of the pre-Islamic period?"
قال عليه الصلاة والسلام لا.
The Prophet عليه السلام said, "No, none of this will be any benefit to him." يعني ما تكافئه.
نعم. مات قبل نعم. مات في الجاهلية قبل البعثة.
Because he died before the sending of the Prophet عليه السلام. So he died upon disbelief.
لماذا؟ قال عليه الصلاة والسلام لأنه لم يقل يوما رب اغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين.
الله أكبر. The Prophet عليه السلام said to Aisha, that is he will not be forgiven because he never said at all, Oh my Lord, forgive me on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection.
فهو كان يعمل في الدنيا وللدنيا وما كان عنده أي شيء عن الآخرة فلا يعفو يغفر له في الآخرة.
So he used to do many good deeds and many charitable things, but they were all for this dunya, being heedless about the meeting of Allah in the hereafter.
وأنا متأكد.
And I am completely sure.
أن هذا الذي على حسن الخلق وهو ليس بمسلم لو عرف الإسلام الصحيح. ولو عرف أخلاق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نبينا محمد كان يجي الأعرابي. تعرفون الأعرابي؟ أنتم عندكم أعراب؟
بدوين.
عندكم؟ ما عندكم ها؟
ما عندنا توبليس.
لا إحنا عندنا كثير.
آسف أخطأت. لم أترجم السؤال بالإنجليزية. I'm sorry, I never translated the question in English. The question I asked, what does Allah say about a righteous man who conducts himself with respect to Allah's good conduct standing? However, is not a believer in Allah. So from this question, what I forgot to translate in English, the Sheikh went into the story of Abdullah ibn Jad'an, who died before Islam, and he had many good deeds and many charitable organizations.
ما في مثله في good deeds.
And there was no one, anything like him in the affair of doing good deeds. And Aisha asked the Prophet alayhi salam, will he be in paradise? And the Prophet said, no, because not one day did he seek Allah's forgiveness on the day of when he will meet Allah on the day of judgment.
الشاهد.
And the Sheikh also said, Barakallahu Fikum, he said, the individual who asked this question here, I'm sure that he, if this man who asked this question, who has these noble characteristics, that if he were to have known about Islam, with true knowledge,
ونبي الإسلام.
And the Prophet of Islam, that he would have accepted Islam. If he knows about the reality of Islam, he would accept it.
كان الأعرابي يجي يقول يا محمد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. أخلاق يا أخوان، هذا لو عرف الإسلام وعرف نبي الإسلام وعرف الأخلاق في الإسلام سيدخل في الإسلام.
The question if he were to know about Islam and the mannerisms of Islam and the Prophet of Islam and Islam and its truth, then he would enter into Islam.
لكن مصيبتنا اليوم.
But the problem that we have today.
مصيبة إسلامنا.
The problem of our Islam today.
How many Islam we have?
How many types of Islam do we have?
كثير. 73.
سبحان الله العظيم.
73. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.